On the 25th of October 1415, one of England and France's most famous battles occurred, the Battle of Agincourt. King Henry V of England had claims to the throne and invaded Normandy after negotiations failed. Initially, the French appeared to have the upper hand. They were on their home turf, bolstered by the fervent support of the local nobility and peasantry. With a muster of around 10,000 veteran men-at-arms and an additional 5,000 miscellaneous infantry, they certainly fielded a formidable force. In stark contrast, Henry V could only muster a modest 9,000 soldiers, with some 80% of his army consisting of Welsh and English longbowmen. Fortified with stakes, the English held a defensive position, and so it was up to the French to launch an assault. The cavalry charged, but were repelled with hails of arrows striking like sledgehammers against both mount and rider. The horses, however, only armoured on their heads, were prime targets for the bowmen. Injured and panicked, the horses turned and fled back into their own lines, sometimes casting their riders from their saddles in the process. The knight's charge had loosened up the already slick turf, so when the footmen marched up the field, they were forced to slog through churned clay that had softened into pure mud. When they did reach the English, it was said that the French men-at-arms were so exhausted and muck-covered that they could scarcely lift their weapons. That day, many valiant knights found themselves crippled, trampled, and buried in mud, unable to breathe or even stand up. It was such a resounding victory for the English that it heralded a period of success in their campaigns in France and enshrined the conflict as one of the most famous English battles in history.